Now, first I'm focusing what is a variable and what types of variable, that things I'm focusing very briefly. So these things, you know, what is a variable, your quantity or condition that can change. Yeah, so first I'm focusing what is an independent variable. So my presentation purely based on some kind of image based on it, you can easily to grasp the meaning what is an independent. See the case x, y. So what is x? Normally the case of x, we may treat it as a independent variable. Y is a dependent variable. So x is, y we can call as an independent variable in the sense, this is called a causing variable. Normally the independent variable may affect the dependent variable, or it may kind some kind of influence on the dependent variable. The independent variable we may call in a different names like exposure, explanatory variable, and manipulated variable in the context of the experimental method. See the cases, just I'm going to give some example also. In this example, you can easily understand the independent variable, the investigator able to manipulate during the experimentation, then we may call a CM manipulative variable. For example, the effectiveness of flipped classroom strategy on enhancing the mathematics achievement. In this context, flipped classroom is an independent variable on enhancing the mathematics achievement. Mathematics is a dependent variable. So here, as an investigator, you can manipulate the strategy. So based on the students' level, based on the technology which you have, you can change the modification, you can do a lot of manipulation in the flipped classroom strategy. Based on the strategy only, the scores of the students may change. So in this case, x is a causing variable, dependent variable is called as a, this is called as a affecting variable. Now see this example, there's a GIF image also I'm using here. For entertaining you, I'm showing this kind of GIF image. In this image, who is the independent variable, who is the dependent variable? Just you can give the response. So one person beat the one guy, immediately that person still falling down. So those the persons could beat down, that is called as an independent variable. So the person can fall down is called as an independent variable. Normally, some researcher without knowingly, they are taking a very poor independent variable. The poor independent variable cannot affect the dependent variable. Then the entire research to be totally is not be fair. Okay. Exactly. The blue shirt person is independent in this cause. In this example, see here, the values of the independent variable, the liter of water, how much I'm pouring. Sometimes I'm pouring only 2 drops, sometimes I'm pouring the 4 drops. Like that, the investigator can manipulate the independent variable. So the fertilizer amount. Now I'm moving to the dependent variable. The dependent variable here in the case Y is a dependent variable. This is called the effector. See here, normally we may call this dependent variables an affecting variable. Defending variable having different names, outcome variable, explained variable, and response variable. There has different names are there. But in this example, we already discussed about the independent variable. Based on the independent variable influences, what is the effect you are going to found in the sense? The plant height or the plant growth, you are going to measure it. So in this context, amount of water is independent variable. How the amount of water is may influence the height of the plant is a dependent variable, right? The same manner, the amount of fertilizer is independent variable. The height of the plant is a dependent variable. Now see here, what is the issue in this GIF images? Kindly check, kindly any idea. So just I'm showing some funny images. Why I'm intently using? Some people, if you are taking the wrong independent variable, it not be, yeah, that is called wrong variable. If you are not selecting the correct independent variable, damn sure the effect won't be there. See, in this case, the independent variable, the red color shirt, is trying to beat the dependent variable. But the case is what it happened, the independent variable is still falling down. So this is why some of the researcher, without look onto the proper reviews, they are taking to the wrong independent variable. That's why it's not affecting properly in the dependent variable. Okay, that is also issue, is there? That's why better, based on the reviews, you have to select the proper independent dependent variable. Sometimes we may use the different names for independent and dependent. Independent X, dependence Y. Then causing variable, affecting variable. What is the effect variable? Effect represent whether independent or dependent. Kindly give the answer in the chat box. Effect represent what? Independent or dependent? Can you give the answer in the chat box? Yeah, dependent, right? Yeah, exactly, dependent. Manipulating variable in the context of the experimental method, sorry. Experimental method, manipulating variable is an independent. What's a measure variable? Measure variable is nothing but output variable. The output variable is here. What is that? Here we may treat it as a dependent. Then independent variable, dependent, lot of names are there. If you are using only two variables, not at all an issue. Because if you have the X and Y, that is not at all an issue. But if you are keeping the third variable, see this case, I'm using a control variable. Why in the independent experimental method, we can give the control treatment. Why we need some kind of constant variable, we have to keep it constant. Then only we can check the whether our independent variable may 100% may influence the dependent variable. If you are not keeping some variables and control, you cannot be perceive whether your treatment is exactly giving the influence on the dependent variable. See this case, just I'm showing this image to you. In this case, the pouring water, okay, the liquid used to the water is an independent variable. The dependent variable is the plant height, okay? The dependent variable is plant height. But, sorry, there is a short issue. I put the charge. Okay. Yeah, so now it's okay. Yeah. See here, what is the control variable? Even I'm using a different samples, for example, two or three samples I'm using. Here, some of the variables may influence, but we could not predict that variable may influence. But some of the third variable also may influence in the output as well as the input also. That is why see the case, the type of the plant I'm using. Suppose the plant is basically the plant size is very small in the sense we could not be check the height properly. Okay, because that is the nature of the things. Then pot size. Suppose I am using a different sample, two or three samples. I'm using one sample, this kind of small pot. Other sample, I'm using a bit, big pot. Therefore, we could not be getting the exact results whether our independent variable may influence the dependent variable. That's why we have to keep some kind of variable as a controlling factor, like amount of liquid and soil type. That's why once you go for a two variable, not at all issue, X and Y. But once you take it consideration as a Z, so the third variable if you are taking, we may check whether it may act as a confounding variable or mediating variable or moderating variables, because the third variable may influence in different manner. Normally we know X is a causing variable, Y is effect variable. But if you are checking the third variable effect on X and Y, it may influence in a different mode. So what are the mode it may be influence the Z in the sense? First is a confounding. What is confounding variable? The confounding variable, the Z, actually that variable Z is a confounding variable, the third variable. The variable, it may affect both the X and Y. See this image, I hope you are getting. If the third variable may affect the X and Y, it may affect X and Y, both it may affecting because of the Z, then that variable is called confounding. The best example, see here, hours of study. So based on the hours of study, what did happen? The exam score may be changed. So based on the hours of study of the person, the exam score may change. This is we know. This is so independent, dependent. But what is that here the confounding variable based on the subject interest. For example, I am very much interested in statistics. Therefore, normally what it happened, the study interest, the subject interest, it may increase the hours of study. Even the subject of interest also, it may influence the exam score. So therefore, the third variable may influence on both X and Y. So therefore, it's called as a confounding variable. See this image. So I hope you are seeing this person. What you found this? Actually, there is he's maybe X, he may be a Y. What is the person is doing? He's not doing any partial. Okay, he's beating both X and Y. Yeah, of course. So we cannot be all the environmental factors may confound the confounding, because some kind of environmental factor may influence only the independent variable or dependent variable. Kindly check which variable it may be influencing. Okay. So based on that only, so we could not be considered all the environmental factors maybe all the environment may be the third variable, it may be Z, but we cannot be come for conclusion all the Z may be a confounding. Sometimes it may be acted as a mediating variable, sometimes it may be out of moderating variable also. See the next example. This is called mediating. So here I'm using the Z. So I'm using the Z, the third variable. But in this case, there is a part of association between X and Y goes through Z. So here Z is not directly affect the Y. But in this previous case, Z is affecting X as well as the Y. But here what it happened? X is beating Y, X is beating Z. Through the Z also, there is an effect happened to the Y. I hope you are seeing the chart. There is a error mark you are seeing from there. This is called mediating effect. Here, Z is a mediator of X to Y. Here, Z is acted as a mediator between the two persons of X and Y or two variables of X and Y. See this case, I'm taking the consideration of hours of study, exam score as a independent variable. For example, the problem practice. If I increase the hours of study, damn sure what it happen? The attempting the problem practice, it may be increasing. So suppose I'm taking for 5 hours for sitting the study, in the sense I may solve 5 problems. If I sit the 10 hours for study time, I may attend, I may solve nearly 10 problems. Therefore, from the session, what it happened, from the Z, there is an influence on the Y. Therefore, it's called mediating variable. So welcome Amrit sir. So now my HOD is now online. The next thing is moderating variable. What is called moderating variable? So in this case, the third variable may act as a moderator. See this example. The one person, so the center person is stopping the two persons fighting with each other. So he's acting as a moderator for this. But in the previous mediating variable, what you're seeing from here, see here, the mediating X is influence on Y through Z. But in this case, the Z is applying or affecting the influences of X to Y. So the influence of X to Y is affected by the Z. So it's like a moderator. The best example is hours of study is an independent variable. The exam score is a dependent variable. What did happen? Suppose there's a problem with the tiredness. The tiredness varies influence when you go for the exam score in the context of exam. Even he may be studied a lot of hours, but before going to the exam, if you are very tired, in the sense there is a chance the mark may be very less. Okay, so that is also the problem of the moderating variable. So what is called intervening variable? The intervening variable is like a mediator, but through the mediator, but here what is the thing, in the sense if there was somewhat relation with the X to Y, X to Z and Z to Y. The like a linear relationship may be there. See the case, level of education. So if the level of education should increase or decrease, based on the level of education, it may influence the income. Suppose one persons are getting the PhD degree, there's a chance the income may be high. If the income is high, what did happen? What the influence may happen to the Y? Damn sure the spending, the amount also may increase. The same thing, some people are getting the higher education, high in the sense, they may get the better occupation. Through the better occupation, they may get the higher income. So that kind of intervening influence may be there. The next is called active variable. So the people are using different terms in the context of the independent variable, dependent variable. So what is that active variable in the sense? Suppose when you're taking the consideration of the experimental method, our independent variable may be active variable, because which are the variable you are able to manipulate, act to represent. If the variable you are able to manipulate, then it's called active variable. Which are the variable you are not able to manipulate it, then it's called as an attribute variable. In this case, active variable, the example, the effectiveness of flipped classroom strategy. The flipped classroom strategy is an independent variable. As a researcher, you could be able to modify it. You can be able to manipulate the independent variable. Therefore, it's called flipped classroom may be treated as a active variable. Attribute variable, in the case of the demographic variable like age, gender, blood group. Even yesterday you did a t-test. In the t-test, you are taking the consideration of the gender as an independent variable, then the test mark is a dependent variable, or group, control group, experimental group, you can treat it as an independent variable. The scores mark, we may treat it as a dependent variable. So that kind of variable will not be changed. Okay, that is called as an attribute variable. Then demographic variable, you know, based on the sample background, you are targeting some kind of background things like gender, locality, age, that is come with the demographic variable. When you talk about the active variable, attribute variable, there's two classifications in this context. So normally we treated our steady variable as an active variable. Attribute our demographic variable, we treat it as an attribute variable. So the different names will be there while you somebody that doing some kind of statistics technique. That's why I'm focusing this one. Demographic variable, yeah, the case of management is correct. Attribute variable, yesterday you did t-test, no? So all the attribute variable you treated as an independent variable. In the attribute variable, lot of divisions may be there. In the demographic variable, dichotomous variable, if you have only the two classification like male and female, rural, urban, in the demographic variable, then it's called dichotomous. Only two, di means two, di represent two. I hope you know, you understand. Normally, whenever you use the term di represent two, tri represent three. If you classify the demographic variable into three, then it's called as a trichotomous, like urban, semi-urban, and rural. Normally, in the case of the dichotomous variable, if you're taking the consideration independent variable, we can go with the t-test. Because for the t-test assumptions, our independent variable should be only the two categorical. But in the case of the ANOVA, our independent variable should have the three classification. So minimum three classification, then we can go with this kind of urban, semi-urban, rural. With the emotional intelligence, we can go with the you can go with ANOVA or ANCOVA. Then multiple variable, if more than three subgroups, three category, then it's called multiple variables. Arif Kumar, I hope you are understand from this example. Die means two classification, tri means three classification. More than three, we may treat it as a multiple. Then the third is called extraneous variable. Due to the time fact, I'm skipping this because the extraneous variable is nothing but a confounding variable. If you want, I will highlight some kind of example. This is for the education side example. Normally, I'm taking the title like this. See here, there's a title, the impact of learning format and teaching style. Therefore, on exam performance. Can you tell in this study, what is the independent variable, dependent variable? Anyone can highlight what is independent variable, dependent variable?
Exam performance is dependent variable.
What is it? Sorry, I'm not able to get your voice, please. Anyone?
Exam performance is a dependent variable, sir.
Whereas okay. Yeah, exactly. Thank you. See this case. What is the intention variable? Normally, when you're taking the research, we are intentionally selecting some variable. What is the intention here? I'm going to check what's my intention, what's my aim. I want to check whether my teaching style, it may be influencing on the exam performance. Therefore, in this case, learning format or teaching style may be independent variable, the exam performance is dependent variable. Here, this year thinks that what is that the investigator can already intend to select this variable as an independent dependent variable. Therefore, the intention variable is a studying variable. Which are the variable you are studying, then it's called as a independent, that is called an intention variable. In this intention variable, there is an independent variable. What is our independent variable intention we are selecting? Learning format and teaching style. So what is the dependent variable for intent we are selecting? That is called exam performance. But there is an extraneous variable. There is a difference between intention and extraneous. What is the difference between intentional and extraneous in the sense? The intention we are keeping some independent variable, dependent variable. But the third variable, we could not be find even the third variable may influence on the dependent variable as well as the independent variable. So there is no thumb rule, Sandhya Kumar. There is no thumb rule for independent variable, dependent variable. So you can change as you like. That is, you can discuss with the guide. You can first you can keep it a dependent variable or change, but you have to change the sentence format. So there is no thumb rule on it. Okay, and better for the layman, for the research is better to reach the layman's too. Therefore, better if you want to reach your research project things to reach the layman's, better you can go with a very simple manner like independent to dependent. Then only the people's, even the those who not know the researcher, those who read the topic, also they can easily understand. That is why our research, don't be put your imagination word and all, don't put high languages while making the title in the title frame, because your project work your research work may reach the layman's also. Therefore, you can write the topic as well as write the content based on the level of the layman's. That also you have to think in the mind, right? But in the context of the external is a variable, what has happened, the external is a variable. This variable we are not intentionally to find, but the third variable may affect the influence of the independent variable and dependent variable. See here, even the external variable having some kind of independent variable. What is the external variable, independent variable? Sometimes the quality of the teacher, even you are, I am adopting a very good strategy, but I am not very good in communication skill. I'm not able to explain well properly. Therefore, what will happen? The quality of the teachers also, it may be affecting the learning form. Then how we can come for conclusion that teaching method is not be effective, or the teaching methods to be effective. So that is a problem with it. The next thing, the dependent variable also may affect with this kind of some kind of external variable. What is the external variable and the dependent variable? The student tiredness. What will happen if the students getting the tiredness before the examination? Damn sure what will happen? The exam performance also may influence it. Therefore, what we have to do, we have to nullify this kind of third variable effect with the use of ANCOVA or partial correlation. So that's only I'm going to deal now. Yes, the same example, I mean, go with some kind of commerce example. See here, the relationship between the background music, it's a general, it's not a common, okay. Anyway, it's like a commerce based only. The background music and task performance among the employees of packing facility. So anyone can tell what is that independent variable in this case? What is the independent variable? Intention independent variable. Intention means anyone.
Background music.
Ah, yes, exactly. So the intention variable is a study that our variable that our research want to examine. So the researcher intensely want to do that research in the particular variable, that is called intentional. So he is taking the consideration independent variable as a background music. What is the dependent variable? Task performance.
Task performance.
Where is the task performance? But the third variable, what is our third variable? The external variable may affect both X and Y. See the case of independent variable of external variable. Sometimes the types of background music. So here they are giving us a background music only. In this case, independent variable type of background may be a classical music or a Western music or pop music. So some people like a pop music, some people like the Western music, some people go with the very classical music. So the music sound also may influence. Here we are putting only background music, but the background music of the type may be influencing. The loudness of the, even some people very much like to go hear the songs very slow sound. Some people moderate sound, some people have high volumes. Therefore, this kind of third variable may influence the background music. Similarly, the dependent variable of the external variable, it also may influence the dependent variable. What is called employee tiredness, employee motivation, job satisfaction. Suppose you are not satisfied with your job, damn sure what it happened, it may influence the job performance. Then how we can justify that the background music only is contributing to the dependent variable. So a lot of third variable may influence on it. For that, we have to use some kind of techniques to eradicate this kind of third variable effect. Just I'm skipping this one. And the other one is called composite variable. That is called as when you go for a factor analysis, you can understand what is a composite variable that I'm talking tomorrow.